Especially struggling with menopause, everything I can do, we didn't even look to our my gut microbiome. But I have a leaky gut. And 2 years ago, I didn't have a leaky gut.
It's very common. And I think a lot of even providers, quite frankly, don't say to their patients, you have a diagnosis of lupus or psoriasis or rheumatoid arthritis or celiac disease. And they're not saying, well, what came before that diagnosis was a breach in this one cell layer thick of the small intestinal lining. So our small intestine just has one cell layer thick. And part of that, it's both good and bad. Small intestine is where we absorb nutrients and vitamins and minerals and food. What starts to happen is as we're navigating perimenopause and menopause, estrogen is this very important hormone for immune cell regulation. And what a lot of people don't realize is, you know, chronic stress, ultra processed foods, which are thinking about the alterations in the gut microbiome that are vis-a-vis a reflection of changes in estrogen or estradiol, which is this predominant form of estrogen that our bodies make. What ends up happening is we get alterations in the microbiome. We end up developing a leaky gut. The leaky gut will trigger this immune response. The immune system and the gut are very interwoven. It's almost like they're side by side with one another. So when you mentioned that you know that prior to menopause, you didn't have a leaky gut, now you do, much more common to see women developing autoimmune conditions in menopause.